Setting the confidence level in SPSS. How do we get confidence intervals in SPSS? Most of the times we just get them and we don't have to do anything special. For example, if we do a t-test on means, let's have a look at the one sample t-test, and we have a look at the options, then we see that, you know, by default there is a confidence interval reported and the confidence level is 95%. If you want to change this, just change it here. So with t-test on one or two means, under options you can change the confidence level, and if you don't change anything, you'll get the 95% confidence interval. Okay, now how about a one-way analysis of variance? Here it is, a one-way ANOVA. The ANOVA itself is an F-test and there's no confidence interval to it, but if we do post hoc tests, for example Bonferroni test, we basically do a t-test and there's a confidence interval to the t-test. You don't have to ask for it, you'll get the confidence interval and the confidence level will be 95%. If you want to change the confidence level, you have to do it here, after significance level. For example, if I enter 0.01, then the confidence level will be 99%. Right, that's a one-way analysis of variance. How about two-way analysis of variance? We do that with general linear models, univariate. I will select weight as a dependent variable, color as a factor, and then there is a post hoc button, just like the one-way analysis. I can select my factor and select a type of post hoc test, but if we're looking here, there's no way to change the confidence level. If we want to change the confidence level, we need the options, and there we find the significance level option. If I change it to 1, then SPSS here is so friendly to tell us that the confidence interval level will be 99%. All right, that will be for analysis of variance and means. Now, how about regressions? In regression analysis, we have to ask explicitly for confidence intervals. The option is not checked automatically, so we have to check it to get confidence intervals for our regression coefficients. And of course, here we can change the confidence level as well, as we like. So that's the way we get confidence intervals to a regression analysis. How about correlations? Correlations are a bit of a problem. Imagine I want to know correlation between candy weight and candy sweetness. But under options, there is no option to get a confidence interval for the correlation coefficient. If you want a confidence interval for a correlation coefficient, we must bootstrap. With bootstrapping, we will get a confidence interval and we can adjust the confidence level here. Right, so bootstrapping, of course, always gives us confidence intervals. So if there is some statistic for which you want a confidence interval, but you cannot find it in one of the tests that I've discussed so far, then do bootstrapping. For example, we can use frequencies to get the median of a variable. Let's say median weight. Under statistics, I can get the median. Now, this median will not be reported with a confidence interval. If we want a confidence interval for the median, we must bootstrap. And there it is again, the same dialog screen. And here we can adjust the confidence level of the confidence interval. Well, that's about all there is to say about confidence intervals in SPSS, how to get them, and how to adjust the confidence level.